Okay, so here we have the AR Wing Pro. We're just going to kind of do a quick walk around and talk about how I have things set up and laid out in the airplane. It's just something that people were asking me to do, and I kind of totally skipped over the build with this one. I never really did a like unboxing and review build type of thing. I just went right into flying it, and I gotta say, I've been having a lot of fun flying this one. So we'll start by removing the main hatch. We'll sit it out of the way, move the rear hatch, sit it over here. And we can take a look in these side hatches also. So obviously the heart of the operation is the flight controller. This is a Matic F405 wing. Now I realize I'm recording this with my GoPro, kind of for an overhead view, but I realize some of this stuff is not going to be the easiest to see from this point of view. So I will go back and I'll grab my other camera right over here that's sitting out of the way. And I'll probably do some kind of still images or maybe some little video clips or whatever, and I'll overlay some of the stuff that I'm talking about here in the video. So we'll start by taking a look at the flight controllers. The Matic F405 wing, which is running Arduplane firmware. We have a Dragon Link 900 megahertz receiver sitting right over here. This is the 1000 milliwatt or 1 watt high power output for the radio modem, which I'm using for telemetry. And we'll take a look at some of the wiring in a minute too. I'm just kind of running through it. Over in this side cover, we have the GPS, which normally goes in the back cover. It actually comes with a little GPS plastic cover, the little kind of styrene, I think it is, whatever plastic it is, a little plastic cover that sits right here. The intended spot for your GPS is right here. But as you can see, I have a little LED strobe here. So I'm running my GPS right over here. And over in this side bay, we have an 800 milliwatt Partom video transmitter. It's running on a 1280 megahertz. And you can see I have a little antenna coax coming in from the wing. I have a center fed dipole out here in this wing tip. And same thing for the Dragon Link receiver. You see my coax kind of comes in right here, runs through this little pocket out into the wing right out here to another center fed dipole on this side. Included servos. And this is all the motor, the ESC, and the servos were all included with my kit from Sonic Model for review. I believe they're the same ones with the plug and play. But I'm not 100% positive, so don't quote me on that. But the servos that I have in this one are super, super nice servos. They're analog servos, which means they tolerate the 900 megahertz well. You can see I have, 4 or 5 inches tops separation from my antenna right here to my servo sitting in this bay in the wing. And like I said, this Dragon Link transmitter is putting out 1 watt of power for telemetry, transmitting 1 watt on 900 megahertz right here. And this servo is 100% immune to it, which is a good thing. And I've actually run into that problem with digital servos in the past with 900 MHz systems. The 900 MHz RF energy will interfere with a lot of digital servos. So these being analog is one less thing to worry about. They work 100% fine. And I have flown this on both 433 MHz and the 900 MHz system that's in it now. And I had the 433 receiver antenna in the exact same location and mounted in the same little cutout in the foam and had zero issues. So that's a really good trait for those servos, good positive thing for that, for those. And but as far as performance, they're strong, they're fast, there's, you know, zero slop in them. I 100% like these servos. Sonic Model, if you're listening, please make these available as a standalone purchase. Let me buy these by themselves. I'll buy them and run them in my other airplanes. Previously, I've been a big fan of the Emax ES08MA2, I want to say. Not 100% sure on that model number. I think I actually have one of the digital versions sitting right over here. No, this is not it. It is here. ES08MD, so that's the digital one. I run the analog, the ES08MA2 Emax servos is what I was previously using for my favorites. I like these better, though. ESC that was included is the Sonic Model 40 amp ESC. It does have a nice switching BEC inside that's rated at 5 volt 3 amps, but I am not using it because the Matic flight controller has an inbuilt BEC that works well. So as you can see, this is my ESC lead right down here. I just have it, the red wire is clipped. I'm running just ground the signal into the ESC1 port on the flight controller. So, and of course, you know, your power leads run back to your motor. That the motor that was included is a Sunny Sky 2216-7, which is a 1400 kV. motor, and now I'm currently running a, I want to say it's a 7x6 APC-E prop. Let me see, I'm having trouble reading that. Yep, 7x6E prop. And that's a standard APC. It came with an 8x5 composite prop, which ran fine. It ran smooth and made good power and everything, but I wanted to run the 7x6 just to get a little bit more pitch speed. And it does seem slightly more efficient, so that's the prop I've stayed with for now. Like I said, we can drop this extra hatch back on now, the rear hatch. Like I said, I'm running my GPS in this side bay because I thought it was a good spot to mount a strobe light right back here. So you can see I just have this little 3D printed cover that fits over it. This is a Strix or Strikes, not exactly sure how you pronounce that. But anyway, it's a little strobe light, strobe LED from Ready-Made RC. You have a red light and a clear light. You can change the strobe pattern and things like that. And you see I just have this little 3D printed cover, which kind of press fits in place of the GPS cover that would normally be there. Have a little cutouts for the two LEDs and a spot where you can reach your little button to change your pattern. So it works well. And last thing we haven't mentioned yet is the Caddx Retail flight camera nested right down in the little cutout right there in the nose. Works well. I guess we can flip it over and take a look at the underside. And we'll look at these two antennas, how I have those set up. Before we do that, though, I just want to kind of run back over it. This one is the 900 megahertz center-fed dipole, which is for the Dragon Link receiver. This one is a 1280 megahertz tuned center-fed dipole, which is for the 800 milliwatt part-time video transmitter that's mounted right into this side bay. So I will flip the plane over and show you how I have the bottom of those antennas set up. Okay, so now we're looking at the underside of the wing. It's just laying on the bottom side of the wing there. Now this is the bottom of the video transmitter, so we flipped the plane over obviously. But you can see I have this little extra piece of foam. This is some of the extra foam that was included on some of the front camera covers and things like that. I just trimmed a little piece and hot glued it to this little bay, because there is a little cutout bay you can mount some equipment out here if you want to, if you decide to do that. But I just glued this little piece of foam here just to make kind of a little skid, just to protect the antenna. If you see the bottom half of that antenna, it's just a thick piece of silicon coated wire, basically like some about 16 gauge motor wire basically, and it's just free to flex when I land. Normally it'll hold its shape in the wind and things like that. When I get ready to launch the airplane, I'll just kind of straighten these two antennas out, make sure they're straight before I take off. And they hold their shape until you land. They're free to just fold right back with no damage. And it just kind of lands on this little skid here that I added just to keep it off the ground so it doesn't damage it too bad. And same thing over on this side. This one is actually just a piece of wire that was part of the 900 MHz Dragon Link antenna. I just removed the little plastic tubing, little guide that holds it straight. And the wire tends to maybe flex a little bit in the wind. I'm assuming it does. I don't have an actual way to see that in flight and know. But I'm assuming it blows back a little bit in the wind, but it's free. You know, it's fine. It's free to blow, change its shape or whatever. It doesn't really affect the antenna tuning a lot. Not enough to matter, at least. Just make sure you have your grounded element hanging down and the active element on the top. You want that active element to stay vertical. And once again, I have a little skid right down here. And it just kind of protects that antenna. So when I land, they just fold back. So that's what's going on with those antennas. I just wanted to kind of explain that. And you can see the coax just runs out to these cutouts. I actually cut a little channel through here. Well, there was a channel that was ran along here and it turned and went back. And there's an extra servo connector down here. There's actually two of them. I'm only using one in each wing. Just the servos is the only wiring I have out into the wings besides these antennas. So the empty connector is just under here. It's just taped over with some clear tape to keep everything smooth and streamlined. But I just kind of continue that little channel up to here. And then that coax wire goes down. And the same thing with this one. It comes around here and then goes down. And I'll give you a look at how they make it into the fuselage here. You see this coax? Like I said, it just kind of comes down. And so that it hits the center of that wing. And then if you look down in here, there's a cutout. I made a cutout here through this little piece of the root. So this side is actually larger than this one. It's cut out big enough to make room for the 90 degree connector that I have on the end of this coax. I needed to use a 90 degree connector to make room for all of this to fit, because this video transmitter is a little bit longer than the bay. And I couldn't do it with a straight connector, so I used a 90 here, which is fine. Just make sure it's, when I tuned it, I used my little nano VNA to tune that antenna and got everything actually tuned up perfect for 1280 at the connector here. So you see the back of this transmitter is actually sitting back into the cutout where the airflow is supposed to exit this bay, which does impede my airflow a little bit, so it's not really ideal, but it is adequate. I've got some pretty long flights on this one, and I always check it when I land because I was somewhat concerned about that. But when I land the airplane, the transmitter is running totally cool. It's barely warmer than ambient, so it's totally fine. And same thing with this one. I have a little cutout at the root here that joins that coax. When I slide the wing over the spar, I just push that connector through, feed it through. And this one's a smaller cutout, so you can see I was able to use a straight through connector here for the Dragon Link receiver. So I just feed that through and connect it up, and we're good to go. So as far as the rest of the wiring, the camera cable just runs through, passes through this bay. You can maybe see it. It runs down there, comes out through the little cutout that's already in the airplane, and it plugs into the flight controller to the video input. Video output is this other cable, which runs back through the other cutout back here, which is plugged into the side of the video transmitter. You can't really see it, but that's pretty simple, self-explanatory stuff. GPS is plugged into a UART right over here. Its cable runs through the cutout, plugged into the GPS. Very simple. Then on another UART up here, we have two wires, which is my transmit and receive telemetry, which runs back to some of the pins on the receiver, Dragon Link receiver. I have those mapped for Mavlink telemetry. And so they just run telemetry through those two wires. Obviously, we don't need power, and ground is grounded through this other cable, which is plugged in right here. I have power and ground. I'm actually pulling power from the servo rail rather than the S-bus input port. Because the high-output Dragon Link receivers tend to pull a little bit more power than the Matek flight controller boards are rated for on that receiver power bank there. So I'm just pulling it off of the higher output PEC that feeds the servos. We're only running two servos anyway, so there's more than enough reserve power to run the receiver. So I have my power and ground, and then you see this orange wire is broken off, and it runs into the S-bus input pin right over here. And this other wire is analog RSSI, and I was running the digital RSSI within the S-bus stream, but the last flight I switched that up to analog RSSI. It's just running to the RSSI output pin, which is mapped on one of the banks on the receiver back here, just to try that. And it does tend to work better with the 900 megahertz system for now, because they will be updating that, I believe, get it to work a little bit smoother or linear. But for now, I'm using analog RSSI. Just one more little wire to run. That's my two servos, which are ran out to those connectors which get plugged in when you install the wings. It's just for the Elevon servos. And the only other cable here, which is running into the back, it's just plugged in here. That's the power for the LED strobe light. There's no signal or anything set up on it. It's just pulling power off of the servo rail to run that. And of course, we have our 5.2 5200 4S Turnigy. This is the 12C. 24C is 12C sustained. This is basically a rebranded Multistar pack, is what this is, when they changed the name back to Turnigy. And the power input right there. Power output to the ESC just runs through a little cutout, and I actually took the ESC cleanly. All the wires are really short. I actually slipped that through and soldered it together right inside the fuselage right here. Just keep everything neat. And like I said, those two extra connectors in the wings that I'm not utilizing, I just kind of took those back. You can see the servo connectors on the end of those right here. They're just laying in here in the back just to keep them neat out of the way. Until if I ever need to put any more gear into the wings, I can use those. But for now, I'm not. So they're just tucked out of the way. And about the last thing to point out is in the camera blank, because I'm not using a GoPro or anything in those, but I do need some weight. So I have a little block of metal that's kind of just shoved up into this blank that tucks right into the place of the GoPro. It just kind of snaps in there. It's friction fit. Two little knobs catched on the sides. And that helps me attain my center of gravity. And you can see the 5200 4S just fits. I actually changed the Velcro strap. I'm using a different one than what came with the airplane. A little bit shorter one that fits. But you can see if I remove the battery, there's actually a bit of foam cut out here and here. I just had to hog out a little bit of foam just to make it a little bit easier to fit. More or less, mostly just to have a place to tuck those wires at the end of the battery pack there, so it fits nicely in there and doesn't really bind up or anything. And like I said, I did change out this Velcro strap for one from Defiance RC with a nice strong metal buckle, just because I had it on hand and it was the perfect length. So it keeps everything neat and clean. So that's been a walk around of my AR wing. And like I said, I will be editing. Well, you've already seen it by now, but I'm going to go back over and take a few close-up pictures and things, just kind of show more detail about the stuff I was talking about. So hopefully that gives you an idea of how I have it working, how I've laid things out, how it works, how it's built, and maybe answer some questions. One last thing I want to point out, these ball linkages, I really like those. Those were included with the kit. They're ball links with screws, lock nuts on both ends, zero slot, very strong. It's just overall a nice build. Really like this setup. Really having fun flying with it. Works well and it's efficient. So, yeah, thank you for watching the video. Just kind of doing a few little things like this while I'm not able to fly. The weather is not the best right now. So figured we'd knock out some of this stuff and get it out of the way. So thank you for watching. Keep an eye out for what's to come in the future. See you then.